Hey, I'm Kez. In this quick video, we're going to be looking at the question of what is Figma? So in a nutshell, Figma is an interface design software that runs in the browser, but it's actually a lot more than just that. At the moment, I would describe it as probably the best application to support team-based collaborative design projects. So Figma gives you all the tools that you need for the design phase of a project, including vector tools that are capable of fully-fledged illustration, as well as prototyping capabilities and code generation for handoff. Even though Figma is browser-based, there are desktop applications for both Windows and Mac. Assumedly, these are wrapper applications running a browser inside them. Whether they are or not, either way, Figma is still always running online within those apps. Although if you do lose connectivity, you can still keep working on a document that you have open before you lost your connectivity. But that always online nature of Figma actually provides some of the greatest strengths of the tool. One of those great strengths is that Figma allows for live, real-time collaboration. So you and your team members on a project can all log in to a design at once and you can simultaneously make changes to it. So you can experiment with different elements of your design together, with each person able to actually implement some of their suggestions in real time while working on a design with everybody else. And the fact that these designs are hosted centrally online means that you no longer have to worry about any team members falling out of sync with the project. The latest changes are always there on a design, and it also means that you don't have to worry about transferring files in between team members or pushing files to and from any third-party storage that you might be using. And this also means that you can jump into a design at the same time as a client. So if you're in a separate location to your client, that means you can still have those types of sit-down meetings where the client can ask you to do something, you can implement it in real time, and you can work with the client to get the design to the point that they would like it to be. And on top of all these live collaboration tools, you also have the ability to add comments directly onto the canvas. So if you and your client or your teammates are not able to look at a design at the same time, you can still communicate within the design document itself. You can also build up libraries of reusable components that your whole team has access to. So that means that your team's going to be able to get a head start on various designs. And also, whenever a component is updated, the changes to that component are going to roll out across the design for everybody all at once. For prototyping, you can create connections and hotspots throughout your design so that you can simulate how a user would flow through that interface. For the coding phase, Figma can generate SVG code, CSS, and also iOS or Android code. So I've been talking mostly about the team and client-based collaboration tools, and they are a great strength in Figma, but the other area that really makes Figma stand out from other applications is actually the sum of all of the little things that it does really well. There's a really long list of all these little things that Figma does really well, and we put a whole bunch of them into a series called Figma Tips. And you'll find a link to our Figma tip series on this page where you can see all of these different tips. There are too many to cover here, but I'll give you a few quick examples. In Figma, a node in a vector can have multiple segments coming off it, as many as you like. Usually a node in a vector can only have two segments coming off it. But with Figma, you can have as many as you want, which allows you to create more complex shapes. And in Figma, these are called vector networks. Another example of a cool thing you can do in Figma is you can easily import and place several images into a gallery style layout. Just click, 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 click. Another example of a small thing done really well is when you move an object around on the canvas in Figma, you'll see its height and its width reflected in the rulers, so that makes it a lot easier to place things exactly where you want them. And when you're working with SVG, you can directly copy SVG code for any vector object that you've created in Figma, and then you can paste that code into your project. And conversely, if you have some SVG code that you've gotten from somewhere else, you can paste that code straight into Figma and it will show up as a graphic. So there are a ton of examples of things like this that are really cool that Figma can do. And those are just a few of them. So to sum up what Figma is a browser-based UI and UX creation application with excellent design, prototyping, and code generation tools. It's currently arguably the industry-leading option for collaborative interface design with robust features that support teams working on every phase of the design process. If you're interested in learning more about this awesome tool, Figma, be sure to check out the links on this page and take a look at our courses and tutorials. Thank you very much for watching this video, and I will see you in the next one.